This is what I shoot. If you like it, if you like the model, you can go down to the description and you will find her social media links. Go send her some love, not your gigs. Let's start with our favorite topic, overheating. Nothing at all. Yesterday was a hot day. It was about 30 degrees Celsius, but our shoot was, as you can see, in the forest. We were in the shadows, but still it was hot and there wasn't any sign of overheating icon. Any sign, not 3 bars or half bar, there wasn't at all. Probably I'm doing something wrong, but I shot most of my videos in 4K 60 frames per second and a few clips at 1080 180. There wasn't any problem. Next, battery life. And actually this is another big complaint about this camera. What can I say to you? It was about 2 hours of shooting, 35 minutes of footage. On one battery. Actually, I don't know how much exactly energy I used. It wasn't red icon, alright? And I brought 2 extra batteries, just in case. Because I used to change batteries. Because my Canon 200D or SL2. It feels like it uses more energy than Canon R8. But maybe it's just a new battery in Canon R8. I don't know. We'll see. But for now, I'm more than happy. Next is autofocus. Autofocus is okay. I wasn't impressed. I used to Canon's autofocus. This is dual pixel 2 and I was thinking it would be better, much better. I don't know. It feels better, but slightly. I was struggling with an autofocus because probably it was too dark and I didn't change my ISO. Because when I shoot in lock, you see very flat picture and have to adapt to shooting in C-lock. And also I have to learn how to color grade it. Alright, next. Picture quality. You can decide for yourself, but I'm more than happy because I came from 8-bit camera and what can I say? Dynamic range, colors, image sharpness. I love it. Probably it's not an R5 leak, but who cares? Not me. The image is awesome, but you should be prepared that file size will be enormous. It's about 2 gigs per minute, 2 gigabytes per minute. I shot 30 something minutes and I brought back 66 gigabytes of footage. Yeah, that wasn't a surprise, but you should be prepared. And you should prepare your editing machine too. Finally, my M1 MacBook Pro was warm. Low light performance. In my previous camera, I was comfortable to shoot on 800 ISO. With this camera, I think it's okay to shoot in 4000. 4600 was maximum ISO I was shooting yesterday. You can decide for yourself, is it good enough for you or not. I think it's usable. I added a noise reduction in Resolve and yeah, it's pretty usable. I don't know how about you, but I was in that situation a few times. Imagine you shooting something, but you do not. Because you forgot to push the rec button. When I got this camera, I was excited about this small feature. Let me show you. Can you see it?
flashing border.
I thought it would help me. Yeah, it did. But I still forgot to push rec button once. In conclusion, there was overheating. First time. Come, where is it?
Let's wait. Yeah. You saw that? Yeah, it stays finally. Finally, guys.
It's 28 degrees outside. Oh, let me check. It's 29 degrees Celsius inside. And my windows are closed and everything turned off. I'm doing it for you guys so you can hear me without background noise. Alright, overall experience. I'm more than happy with this camera and I can recommend it for you if your shooting style is similar to mine. If you have any questions about this camera, write them down below in the comment sections. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because I will post more videos about this camera and my experience with this camera. And yeah, this is it. Bye.